President Trump's friend and longtime advisor Roger Stone walking out of court following his arrest by the FBI Friday morning. Stone is accused of lying to investigators about his alleged attempt to procure hacked emails damaging to Hillary Clinton's campaign and tampering with a federal witness. He maintains his innocence. Stone has been a Republican political operative for decades and a self-described dirty trickster. His exploits during the 2016 campaign were chronicled in the Netflix documentary, Get Me, Roger Stone.
These attacks on me by him and by his surrogates, I find this most satisfying. I hope he's laying awake at night worrying about what I'm going to do next.
He's a little bit like the Joker in Batman. I mean, he gets a kick out of doing this. To some extent, his pleasure at burning down the house is infectious for people. And as a reporter, you call him up because you want the outrageous quote.
Roger's, relationship with Trump has been so interconnected that it's hard to define what's Roger and what's Donald. While it will be clearly a Trump presidency, I think it's influenced by a Stone philosophy.
And this morning we're joined by one of the film's directors, Morgan Pechmeh. Morgan, good morning. That Paul Manafort quote is pretty eye-opening.
Yeah, it's very illuminating. Roger has been the closest political advisor to Donald Trump for over three decades. And in a lot of ways, as we show in our movie, he fashioned Trump's approach to politics.
When you heard about the arrest, saw the arrest yesterday, as somebody who spent so much time with him working on this documentary, what was your reaction?
Well, I think it was a long time coming. Mueller had been encircling Roger for some time, and Roger had even anticipated that he would be indicted at some point. And yet it stretched on for so long, it seemed like it might be another addition to the legend of Roger Stone that he could even skate the Mueller probe.
You kind of portray him as someone who knows exactly where the edge is legally but never seems to cross it. So how did you react to this?
I was a little surprised by what Roger put in writing, being that he's so well schooled in the history of cover-ups in American politics, particularly Watergate. I was surprised that he would send texts and emails that appear to be incriminating.
I tell you, 5.5 years you followed him, and I think about this. One, how did you gain the access? I mean, how did you penetrate? And this is during the time that those Clinton emails were being discussed. What's your recollection?
Well, we started following Roger in 2011, and at that time, he was kind of a down-and-out dirty trickster, a vestige of another era, and so he was actually really receptive to having some sort of camera on him. But over the years, we kept going deeper and deeper down the rabbit hole, and this 29-year experiment that he had to make Donald Trump the president of the United States unfolded before our eyes.
So the Trump presidency was just like the cherry on top for you.
It seemed ludicrous to us, just like it did to the rest of the nation, that Donald Trump could be the president. But every 4 years since the mid-1980s, Roger was banging the drum saying that Trump could be the president, that he could win, and he was ridiculed whenever he would bring that up, and he got the last laugh.
He said outside of court yesterday, the only thing worse than being talked about is not being talked about. Is he enjoying this on some level?
I think on some level. I mean, certainly Roger doesn't want to be indicted. He doesn't want to go to prison. It's been a great burden upon himself and his family. Mm-hmm. But Roger also adores the spotlight. And one of his other aphorisms, the Stone's rules that are highlighted in our movie is, never pass up an opportunity to have sex or be on television. And so, having the glow of the lights on him is always something that Roger really loves.
You talk about that Stone philosophy, and you say that that is part of the Trump presidency that we see now.
Yeah, so, these Stone's rules, among them, attack, 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 never defend, admit nothing, deny everything, launch counterattack. This is the playbook that we've seen come out of the White House. And these are rules and an approach that Trump really learned from Roger himself.
I have a question about Friday and the pledge that Stone made. He said he would not bear false witness against the president. Was that code in any way?
Well, I think that Roger, were he to be convicted, would be toward the top of the list for a presidential pardon. That being said, Roger has genuine affection. He has love for Donald Trump. And I think that, you know, we would have to see some superseding indictment with much serious charges for Roger to even begin to think about flipping on the president. I think his loyalty is real.
Okay. Because I was going to ask you, I mean, how does he deal with pressure? Because he's under a lot right now.
Roger deals very well with pressure. He's been in the crucible of American politics for decades now, at the highest level within the White House, on the outside. He can stand the heat.
It's really a fascinating documentary if people haven't watched it, and shows him all the way back to a young child what he was like, which is some of the things we see now. Thanks, Morgan.
You can never count out a pardon either. Yeah. That's always hanging in the balance. Thank you, Morgan.
Thank you so much.